Hi, I'm Denise McLeod.
And I'm Whitney Hunt. I'm sorry.
Whitney, what is so funny? Share it with us.
You.
Oh, I'm funny. Thank you.
You say something or do something, it makes me laugh right before we start, and you start the intro, and I'm laughing in the middle of it.
Well, I know.
That is not fair.
Well, I'm sorry. It's just, I guess it's my face.
It is.
Okay.
It is. But you know what? I'm okay opening the show with a little laughter. So
okay.
That's it's
fine.
All right.
Okay. So Christmas is almost here.
Christmas
we'll
is coming.
Just say that.
Yes.
And so we thought we would do a Christmas show.
Yeah.
And so we thought, well, what can we talk about, you know? So we thought we would get on the internet and we would find some
miscellaneous gifts and gadgets.
Yes, like the top gifts and gadgets for 2021.
Yeah. Yep.
And discuss what we think about those or, you know, recommend them if we have them already.
Yes. So we're going to do a little bit of
search and review.
So if you
don't know what to get, we're going to go through the topics of teens, men and women.
Yep.
We're going to figure it out.
And you know, and overall, you know, this doesn't necessarily have to be a men's gift or a woman's gift. I mean, you know, it's like, I don't know about you, but I'm into tools. I love tools.
I love tools.
You know, I love doing, you know, woodworking and all that stuff. I, you know, tear down trees and all that. So, you know, a men's gift would probably fit for me too.
Hey,
you know,
I have a recommendation right off the bat. Can I just skip ahead?
Oh, God. Okay.
Okay. So, because I also like to work outside and I like to work, well, right now I'm working in the kitchen. But one of my favorite tools that I have is a Black & Decker chainsaw, battery-run chainsaw.
Yes.
And it's like a 40-volt battery, right? It's a 12-inch blade, right?
Yep.
And I use this chainsaw on everything. Now, you don't want to do anything bigger than, say, 6 inches in diameter.
Yeah.
But if you're going to be pruning shrubs or whatever, it's perfect.
Oh, it's great. That's what I didn't have a, it's not Black & Decker. I actually forget what brand it was. But it's similar, electric, you know, chainsaw.
Yeah.
I think mine was a 14-inch chain.
Yeah. Yours was bigger than mine.
Ha! Beat you. and I took down all the trees in my backyard.
Yeah.
Or that surrounded my deck, I should say.
Mm-hmm.
And those things were a biatch. But it did the job. And yes, I agree with you. Highly recommend those.
Yeah, I mean, it's still going to take chain oil. So you got to have chain oil.
Yes.
The thing that I do, I didn't mean to do this, is that I started with a Black & Decker drill that had a 40-volt. It came with 2 40-volt batteries. Nowadays, you buy the drill gun, and then you have to buy the battery separate.
Yeah,
which is asinine. I think everybody complains about that.
Yeah.
So since I had those batteries, I then bought a Black & Decker trimmer, which took the same battery, right? Cool. Very cool. And then you can use the battery for the drill on the. What else do I have? Oh, I have a Zawzall.
All Black & Decker.
I'm not saying Black & Decker is.
It's just a good brand.
I just say if you're gonna have to buy batteries and stuff, you should stick with some. So if you buy DeWalt, you should have all DeWalt batteries, and then you can just switch them off.
Interchangeable,
And you don't have to keep buying batteries because it's interchangeable.
Yeah, yeah. I have a weed whipper that's electric.
Yeah, I love that.
Love it. I mean, I have nothing against gas powered anything. I know a lot of people want to debate, you know, oh, you should go electric because it saves the, you know, earth and energy and all that fun stuff, which I'm down with. I'm totally down with, you know, if you can save some energy, you know, with not tearing up the environment with gas, fine. But the electric, like weed whipper, mowers, chainsaws, all that,
electric is good for, electric trimmer is good for, like a smaller yard.
Mm-hmm.
Not, you know, I think I do an acre of something with it, and it's fine, okay? And now, plus I have two 40-volt batteries, so I can switch off. But, yeah, a gas trimmer you would want if you're doing more commercial, you know, commercial kind of things. If you're doing a couple acres or 3 acres or you're doing an apartment complex or whatever you're working on, that would be gas. But the electric works pretty good for the average homeowner.
I agree.
The Sawzall I just got, and so far I haven't had any problems with it. And I can't think if there's anything else. I think I also have a chop saw. Well, maybe not. Anyway, but I love those tools.
Yes. So electric chainsaws or, you know, any type of gardening, I guess I would say electric tool, look into.
Yeah, it works well.
They're great.
And then the other thing that I like, and, you know, I was, obviously if you got a lot of tools, you're going to buy a tool chest, you can put it in your garage or whatever. What I like to carry around is just a pail from like Home Depot or Lowe's, and you buy the thing that goes, it's like an insert that goes into the pail, and it has all these pockets mm-hmm. on the inside
yep.
and on the outside of the pail.
Yep.
So I just take all the tools that I use, like the hammers and the hammers, screwdrivers, wrenches, anything that you use all the time, I put it in the pail. And then if I have to go anywhere, I just throw it in my car.
Yeah.
I like that much better than just, you know, going through a tool bag trying to find my tool.
Yeah.
But that's pretty cool, too. And that's pretty inexpensive.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like those.
Yeah.
That, and if you have a bucket and you're doing something where you need to sit down.
Yeah.
You
know what? They have a thing that goes on those buckets. It's a seat.
I've seen those. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a swivel thing that you put on top of the bucket, and then you can sit on the bucket and
swivel. And just genius.
Yeah, I know, right? So as a matter of fact, I was going to get you one of those pails with the thing inside of it for your housewarming thing. But then I thought, no, I saw that you have a lot of tool chests. So I'm like, you probably wouldn't want one of those.
It's hard to say. Yeah, side note, people keep asking me, what do you want? You know, as a housewarming gift, blah, 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 blah. And I'm going, I literally can't think of anything.
I just got you a gift card because I'm like, okay, go to Home Depot, get what you want.
And it got me paint, which I really appreciate. And I appreciate everybody, you know, thinking that, you know, they want to get me something for a housewarming gift. I absolutely appreciate that, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But I just don't say.
Right.
And you know the reason why.
So anyway, we kind of went around, but we had to talk about tools. Tools are the best.
Love tools. I ever since I was a wee little one, mm-hmm. I always was a destructive kid trying to tear things apart and put them back together.
Right. Okay. So I'm gonna start with the teens.
Alrighty. Let's see what you got.
I looked on Google and I came up with a personal charging hub. Now, personal charging hub. We could use. I mean, I have one by my bed. I think it's excellent. So obviously you can put your watch. So if you have a watch, like a Fitbit or something,
mm-hmm.
and you can put your iPad, and you can put your telephone, and have it all in one area.
Yep.
And you just drop your watch on this thing and just plug it in, and you're done.
Yep. So it's kind of like one little
one
dock.
Little station. So, yeah, it's a charging station.
Okay.
And I think that's pretty cool. I think that would be good for teenagers.
Yeah.
It's better than having your phone over here in this room and this iPad over here in that mm-hmm. room, and you're always searching for it.
Yeah.
And these are gifts that are between, I don't know if they're, I think charging stations you get for like $30.
Give or take.
20,
I mean,
30 bucks.
Yeah, I would say depending on the brand and how much, you know,
how many?
It's just the specs on it. Is
how many things you can charge?
Yeah, I mean, are you getting an awful Wish, the Wish app? And I'm sorry to say, if it's going to be cheap like that, it's not going to probably do as well mm-hmm. as if you go to Best
and
Buy
some
and get
of them
a $50
have, like alarm clocks built in on the bottom.
Yeah,
so that's pretty cool too.
All right,
so
I dig
that's
it.
That's my first pick for a teenager.
Okay,
personal charging hub.
I'll go with that.
All right, what do you got?
Oh, gosh.
Or do you want me to find something
else? Well, let's see. Like I said, I'm kind of doing this off the cuff. I did not do any research about any gadgets. I just kind of wanted to do a quick search and just see what I could find because I think that's...
Well, I could go again.
Sometimes that's the best thing is when you just do a quick search and go, oh, that's what they're, like, thinking teens or men or women like.
Right.
And it's like...
I could go next if you haven't found one yet.
Well, I'll go with this one. I mean, it's just kind of a comical little gift, you know, a gag gift.
Mm-hmm.
The socks where they have a saying on the foot. So if
you
stick
your
feet up.
Yeah.
And they have a saying, like this particular one I'm looking at says, shh, I'm gaming, and it has a game controller on the other foot.
Yeah.
I actually got my mom a pair of these once for Christmas a long time ago, and it says, F off.
Yeah.
I'm like, that. Yeah, she needs that.
Oh, you also got me a mug that had a middle finger on the bottom. So every
that
time
was
I,
fun.
Every time I drink it.
You were flipping Jamie off.
Yes.
I think she appreciated that.
Yeah, so those are kind of cute.
Yeah, a little gaggy up there.
Yeah.
What else you got?
I have this is for teens again. This is a professional painting 3D pen with OLED display.
Ooh.
So, you know what a 3D printer is, mm-hmm. right? So this is a pen, and we have a picture up so you can see it. And so this is a pen that can draw things like a 3D printer.
Mm-hmm.
And it's $50, and I think any kid would like that. Now, you said you saw this before, and you didn't know about it.
No, I think I have seen this before.
Okay.
I've heard semi-mixed reviews on it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, obviously, again, it's going back to, unfortunately, a price difference. You know, you get a $10 pen.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it's not going to do much. But if you're getting a
if you're like 12 and you want to know, you don't want to get a 3D printer unless you know, the person, you know, the kid would want to know how to use it in general. So if you wanted to teach your child how to use a 3D printer, this would be the great gift.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I have seen these work before where you know, you can literally build a little figurine doll thing.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Know, and it is really cool when you get the right type that works.
Right.
So, yeah, I mean, you just have to do your research. That's all it is.
Yeah. It's kind of cute, though. I like it.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, why not?
What you got?
Okay. Well, let's see here. This is kind of cool. This is kind of more of a teen girl gift,
mm-hmm.
but it's a full-length mirror stand. It has lights on the side,
mm-hmm.
and you open it up, and you can put all of your jewelry in there.
Oh, that's cool.
So it not only is just the mirror, but you can open up, and it's a jewelry. Well, I guess you could put anything in there, you know, not just jewelry, you know, watches, necklaces, earrings, whatever. So I don't know. I guess that doesn't necessarily have to be just for a girl, but
right.
But yeah, it's a full length mirror, has lights on the side, and then you open it up, and then you can put a whole bunch of stuff in it. It's actually kind of neat.
Very cool.
I've never seen anything
like
that.
Are you gonna get one?
No.
Oh, okay. No.
No. I'm sorry. I'm not that girly.
All right.
What's your next one?
So I have the original weighted blanket.
Have one. Love it.
Do you love it?
I have a 12-pound weighted blanket. Yes, and it's amazing.
Yeah. I was gonna say, because like, how do you wash it?
Regularly.
Really?
In cold water.
You can do that?
Yeah.
You've washed it before?
You can wash them.
I just threw mine out.
Why?
Okay, I think that it's pretty cool. And it's cool to have a weighted blanket. But I think the dog laid on it and just got it totally covered in hair.
Mm.
And I'm like, it's too heavy for me to move around. You know what I mean? It's like a blanket that weighs 12 pounds.
It is kind of a bitch to move around.
Yeah.
You know, when you fold it up and then you try to put it on,
you're like, ugh. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And it makes you feel like you're getting an x-ray. But, I mean, I get it. It's weighted to make you feel more comfortable.
Yeah, it's supposed to help with your anxiety.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I think it does.
It does.
But when it comes to, like, getting it out of the way and stuff, it's like, oh, shit, I got to pick up 12-pound blanket. But most people like those. I was just wondering how you washed them because I never washed it. Because it turned into a dog blanket.
I would just do cold water.
Because the dogs like it because it's heavy, you know?
Right, yeah. Of course, they're going to, you know, kind of dig into it a little bit, yeah.
Right.
Okay, so another one I keep seeing going around, I guess not just as a Christmas gift, but just gift in general, are the food themed blankets. So like a tortilla blanket.
Oh, okay.
So you wrap it up and you look like you're in a legit tortilla. Like,
yeah.
Those.
Okay.
Yeah. And my friend actually got his wife one of those types of blankets, mm-hmm. and it looks legit. It's actually quite hilarious.
So that's what you want for Christmas?
No.
Oh.
They're realistic, and it's hilarious, and I think that would be a fun gift to get anybody, and they are very fuzzy.
Okay. They're very fuzzy?
They are very fuzzy.
I like that.
Yes.
I like fuzzy blankets. The ones that don't weigh 12 pounds, I like.
Right. Right, yeah.
Hey, throw me a blanket. Here you go. I'm going to shot put it to you.
And you know that was a TikTok going around?
Really?
That was actually a TikTok thing where when they started getting a little more popular, they would take these blankets, you know, and these blankets would weigh different, you know, mm-hmm. depending on your body weight, you know, 10, 12. I think it went up to 16 or 18 pounds. And there was a TikTok challenge going around where somebody would take the blanket and throw it over themselves or have somebody throw it on them.
Mm-hmm.
And they would have to try to stay standing up, and it would just knock them right over. Literally, I kid you not, look it up, TikTok, the weighted blanket challenge or whatever it was called. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it would just knock them right over.
All right, so my next one is the Harry Potter cookbook.
Harry Potter cookbook?
The unofficial Harry Potter cookbook.
I'm afraid to ask. I don't want to know what the is in it. I mean, no, don't, please don't. Because I mean, if it has anything near what Being Boozled was like.
That's what I wanted to talk about.
Harry Potter flavored.
So this says it's got 150 recipes ranging from cauldron cakes to Harry's favorite. Harry's favorite tart. I don't have my glasses. What I saw there looked like testicle to me. But I'm sure that's not what it was. But the reason why I brought that up is because I want to talk about that game.
Uh-huh.
Bamboozle, right?
Bean Boozled.
Bean Boozled.
Man, Bean Boozled.
And you just got one of those games.
Yeah, we got me the large.
So I think you should tell everybody about that game because that's a fun game to give to your kids.
Okay. So Bean Boozled. This is good. So if nobody's – the Bean Boozled, I think, has been around for years. It is not new. I think it actually came out about Harry Potter time because they had the weird flavors.
Oh, yeah.
On the train.
That's what I had. I had the Harry Potter.
Yep. So they kind of ran off of that. And so Bean Boozled has, I think, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, maybe we'll say around 10 different flavors. And your whole challenge is you spin this little I don't know what you call it.
Dial
spinner. Spinner thing.
Yeah.
It lands on a flavor, and it's either going to be one of two flavors.
Mm-hmm.
So you pick out that jelly bean. It's a jelly bean. And you eat it and hope you get the right flavor. It's not the most pleasant thing in the world because that.
Are we giving away a secret?
No.
What are some of the flavors?
Some of the flavors. Oh, okay. So we had, I think one was like peach and dead fish.
Dirty socks.
And coconut or very much suck. But it's fun.
Yeah,
in the end, it's
it
fun.
Is fun. It is fun.
It was funny because we finally got Lee and Jamie to do one.
That's right. And I would not do it because I know.
You're smart.
Because Jamie came home from work one day and gave me the Harry Potter box of jelly beans. She goes, here, try this. And so I tried one, and that's when I knew, you know, then I just threw it away.
Yeah.
Because it's like, this is fucked up. This is really screwed up.
Well, one of the flavors is, what is it? I think it's like strawberry smoothie or barf.
Yeah.
And
one of them's booger.
And one's booger.
Which is super salty, by the way. That's what Jamie said.
That's so gross. Stink bug.
Yeah.
It's just so bad. The only one that was like
marshmallows
okay,
good.
No mm-hmm. matter which way it went, was the blueberry or toothpaste flavor.
Toothpaste, yeah.
That was okay either
minty.
Way.
Minty.
Yeah.
Minty fresh.
Anyway, all right. So moving on. Any more teens?
No, I'm going to move on.
Okay, so you want to move on to, we'll say,
guys,
men's gifts?
Yeah, guys, what does a guy want?
Okay, so I got to start.
I know what a guy wants, but I mean, what kind of gift does a guy want?
I think they want
Christmas?
That any day, any day of the year. So I gotta say this because this is going around. For some stupid reason, this is like the most popular thing right now that I've been seeing. I don't know if this is true or not.
Mm-hmm.
It's the boxer underwear with the girlfriend or wife's or whomever's face printed on it.
Hmm.
You print your face on their boxers.
Okay.
I don't know why. That's what I'm seeing around lately. Like, that's the thing.
That's the thing?
Yeah.
Okay. I had to find something.
Yeah. So I don't know why you would want to put your face on their... anyway.
Yeah.
And they also have socks.
Funny, yeah.
They've had socks going around, you know, for years, but they started doing the underwear trend.
Right.
So, I don't know.
I'm going to look up a different gift here.
I guess that's like a...
Ah, here we go.
All right,
I got one.
All right.
One of the top gifts for men is a drone.
Oh, yeah.
Who doesn't want a drone, right? So you get them for, what's the lowest, like $70? $50 to get the...
You get a $10 drone if you wanted.
Yeah, and we're talking about tiny, right?
Oh, yeah. They're little dinky plastic...
The wind will take them and put them in a tree. Mm-hmm. But that's how you kind of learn how to fly one first before... Isn't that the recommendation that you get a small one?
Yeah.
And learn how to fly it first, and then you can get a bigger one. Yeah. The bigger one's more steady. They usually have cameras on them, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know more about it than I do because you have
one. Yeah, I mean, if you want to just jump right into like a DJI...
Yeah.
Drone, then
that's recommended.
DJI, you know, go for it. I mean, it's a great brand.
Yeah,
you know,
very cool. The Inspire, you can videotape. You know, you have it on a camera, and you'll have that footage that you want. You can use it for tons of things.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I would say
weddings. You could do weddings with it. You could, I don't know. You could do a bunch of stuff with it.
There's a lot of things that you can
do. Like, I just tried a drone in the summer.
Yeah,
took one home and. And it's the one that drone that actually has a cage over it so that it doesn't get, you don't blow it up, you know.
Was
you
it
know?
Our Mini Mavic?
Yes, it was.
Yeah.
And it's so easy to fly.
Actually, quite as easy. I think people want to.
I mean, if I can fly it, I think anybody can fly. Because I'm like, at first I was like, no, I'm not. See, the first time I seen a drone flown, it was our boss's drone. Mm-hmm. And it was a smaller drone. Mm-hmm. And another person was using it. And flew it right into the top of a tree. And
yeah, that's right.
And so ever since then, I'm like, no, I don't think I want to touch your $2,000 drone because I don't want to ruin it. But honestly, and we do classes at Media Network, right?
We do. We have a little Mini Mavic drone that we do classes with. Yep.
So if anybody is interested in a drone workshop, give us a call, and I'll put the number right here, right here.
Right there.
And it's pretty easy because the first thing you got to do is just go up in the air. Just go up. And it can hover. And it just hovers. Right? It doesn't move anywhere until you move left or right, up or down.
Yeah.
And then it'll move in that direction.
I think what scares people about drones is, one, the privacy, which is actually... You'd have to be, like, in their face to get some sort of decent footage, we'll say that. It's not the most... stealthiest thing to spy on people with.
Well, yeah,
I think that's one fear people have.
When it comes down low enough, you can hear it.
You're going to hear it.
Yeah.
I don't care what kind of drone you have, you're going to hear it. And
like
then, two, you have all your rules and regulations that, you know, if you have
what
to get
you
license,
can and can't
registration.
Do. Yeah.
I mean, there's so
if
many.
If you're by
things
an airport, they're not going to let you fly it.
Yeah.
It's not going to be able to go in the air.
You just got too many rules with it, and I think that also scares people. But anyway, just do your research. You know, if it's something that you really want to go into, then
you want to take it to a park or, you know, out in the middle of a field somewhere. I think it's perfect.
Yeah, just some fun.
Yeah, because we just live in the middle of a field. And, you know, I wouldn't fly it more than a mile. Well, does it even go a mile?
Mm-hmm.
Does it?
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't even fly it in a mile. But then you have
depends
ones
on
that
one
are
get.
More expensive, and you can just click on it, and it'll come home. So,
yes.
Yeah. So those are pretty cool.
Yeah. I do like drones. I do like them.
Very cool shots.
Yes. Another gift for men. I've seen this around a lot lately, and I think it started with the As Seen on TV product.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the universal socket tool.
Mm-hmm.
And it's supposed to attach to a ratchet and essentially fit any nut or bolt that you are trying to unscrew or screw.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I've actually seen this tested, and... let's say at least that one I saw did not go over very well.
Okay.
But I have heard some do work. So I don't know if there's different brands out there. I don't
know.
There
probably is.
Yeah, more than likely.
Right.
You know, I'm pretty sure you'd have to get something a little more steady than just a $5 As Seen on TV.
Mm-hmm.
But that might be a good one to look into, you know, especially if you have somebody that works a lot on whatever projects.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but I've seen that around a lot.
That's cool.
Yeah.
All right. I have a muscle pain gun. I have one of those.
I've heard of those. Those now, look painful.
They're not. JCPenney had them on. They're usually about 40, 50 bucks, 40 bucks up, right? I think they start at 40. But anyway, I got one at JCPenney's for $30 on Black Friday. Wasn't looking for one, really, but I wanted one. And there it was, calling my name. And so I got it, and it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. At first, because they always show that gun in slow motion. It looks like it's pounding the hell out of your skin, you know. No. And it has different attachments that come with it. And it's pretty good. It's got one for your neck. I like to massage the legs because the legs get tired. And I think it's pretty cool.
Okay.
And it's not bad. Those guns are not bad at all. Now, I've seen massagers. The other good massager is, I think it's Homedics or something. They make a massager that goes over your shoulders and behind your neck.
Yeah.
And it has
straps. Yeah, and you put your arms through it, and then you can almost use the weight
and
of your arms.
And it has heat, too.
Yeah.
And that's good for between the shoulder blades and your shoulders
and
your neck.
And you can actually push it down a little bit and, tighten your
and
arms
if you,
up a little bit.
And if you work at an office or something and you're doing 8 hours a day, bent over a computer, perfect. Perfect for that.
Yes.
So I recommend any massager, pretty much.
I do like the ones where it's a full chair massage where you can sit down and then just kind of lean back and it gets you.
I have this massager. Homedics don't make this anymore. But what it basically was a mat. It's a full body massager. You put it on your bed, and you lay on top of it, and it has different modes on it. I don't think they make that anymore. I don't know why. They have chairs.
Huh.
But, it's a full body massager, and it's excellent. Mm. And I it's from, probably the mid-90s,
probably.
So they made it a long time ago, but I love that. Mm. Any massager.
Right, yeah. Just
any heat.
Anything, yeah.
So that's one of mine.
Okay. I'm going to say one more thing for men's gifts, and it's just kind of your basic, and it's no matter what it is. A multi-tool, any type of multi-tool.
Yeah.
So anything like an axe mixed within a screwdriver and a shovel and just any type of mix of multi-tool.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect gift.
Perfect. What I wanted to talk about is, do you know of any games for adults?
No.
Not drinking games, but...
Yes.
But we could talk about drinking games if you want.
You can make any game into a drinking game.
Well, I'm just saying, there's so many, because I was looking at games, because, I'm going to this party, and we're looking for games, and I know that there's, what are those games called? Memes?
Yeah. Okay, so there is one game, and I own it. I think I'll probably bring it in one day.
Crimes Against Humanity...
Cards Against Humanity.
Cards Humanity, yeah.
There's Cards Against Humanity, which has expansion packs, which is absolutely hilarious. And you can get expansion packs that are strictly adult rated.
Right.
And then there's one that is What Do You Meme?
Right.
And it's pretty much a card that has a meme on it. Mm-hmm. And then you have another card that you have to either... You get five cards, I think, with that. And then you decide which of those five cards you want to...
Fits that meme.
Yeah. Then somebody picks the best one.
Yeah.
And it's just hilarious. And like I said, you can make any game into a drinking game for adults 21 and over, 21 and over.
Well, we hope that we had hit on some kind of gifts that you guys might be interested in.
Yeah. I mean it's...
There's so many things out there. It's
there
just too
is.
Much. It's crazy.
There is, yeah.
Too many things. But anyway, we want to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Yes.
We had a great
Stay
time.
Safe.
We had a great... I don't want to say we had a super great 2021.
It was better.
It was okay.
It was
better
right.
than
it was
that right. year before.
Yeah. It's getting there.
Yeah.
It's getting there.
So, but
Hang
we hope
there.
That you have a nice Christmas and
yes.
a Happy New Year.
Yes. Stay safe out there.
Yeah. And we will see you in 2022.
Oh, my goodness. Yes.
All
Here
right.
we come.
Here we go.
Woo!